उपस्थितेभ्यः सर्वेभ्यः नमः गुरवे नमः श्रीरामकृष्णाभ्यां नमः श्वेतफलकम् अत्र अस्ति तस्य मुख्यलाभः कोऽपि नास्ति किन्तु यदि श्वेतफलकं नास्ति चेत् कीदृश अध्यापकः अगर श्वेतफलक भी नहीं है तो फिर कैसा अध्यापक हो तो इसलिए श्वेतफलक है यहाँ पर इसका कुछ उपयोग नहीं होगा। सर्वे कार्यक्रम अति उत्कृष्ट आसन किल छात्र स्वप्रयत्न सर्वे श्रोत शक्नो छात्र स्वप्रयत्न अभी च बहु सम्यक् रीत्या यत्र अभिनयः आसीत् ततु बहु उत्कृष्टः एतादृश कार्यक्रमम् अहं पूर्वम् अपि दृष्टवान् इति अहं वक्तुं शक्नोमि बहु सुन्दररीत्या अपि च बालकानां कृते अपि बहु मनोरञ्जन मनोरञ्जकम् आसीत् तर्हि तदर्थं सर्वे मिलित्वा कृपया मया सह एकवारं हस्तताडनं कुर्मः अद्यतने दिने संस्कृतदिनम् इति दिनस्य विशेषता अस्ति तर्हि एकः प्रश्नः अस्ति किमर्थं वयं संस्कृतं संस्कृतस्य अध्ययनं कुर्मः वै डु वी हेव् टु लर्न् संस्कृतम् तर्हि तत् विषये इन् दट् काण्टेक्स्ट् ऐ वाण्ट् टु से समथिङ्ग्स् लैक् वै डु वि लर्न् संस्कृतम् सो वन् सम् आफ़् द थिङ्ग्स् दट् यु विल् कम् एन्कौण्टर् इन् संस्कृतम् इस् इट्स् अ वेरि सैण्टिफिक् लेङ्ग्वेज् इट्स् अ वेरि प्योर् स्ट्रक्चर्ड् लेङ्ग्वेज् सो वेन् यु कम् अक्रास् संस्कृतं यु विल् नेचुरलि इम्प्रूव् युर् थाट् प्रोसेस् थिङ्किङ्ग् लाजिकल् थिङ्किङ्ग् मेथमेटिक्स् आल् आफ़् दिस् फार् स्टूडेण्ट्स् एस्पेशलि ईवन् फार् वर्किङ्ग् प्रोफेशनल्स् इट् गेट्स् इम्प्रूव् So that's one way of looking at it. Sanskritam is also a very important part of our tradition. So it allows us to connect to our past. So a lot of times in this modern world we miss that connection. So Sanskritam provides us that way. So it's important from that point of view. Sanskritam is the language in which almost all of our scriptures are written. So to know Sanskritam means to be able to read those scriptures and to understand them at a little bit different level. So from that point of view, Sanskritam is very important. All these points are there. Sanskritam is very phonetic. It has a completely different way of saying things and how we pronounce things. For each letter, there is a particular sthanam where it comes from. Like akuha visarjaniya kaitya. So the a, ka, and her comes from the throat. And if you go in front of a mirror and you just say ka, kha, ga, ga, na, cha, cha, ja, ja, na, you will see that where that sounds are coming from. They are organized as per the sounds actually. So it's very scientific, organized language which has immense benefits. Just knowing it increases our respect for that language and our own self-respect and our own confidence that this is something that was there in India and it's part of our culture and we are inheritors of that culture. That is something very mind-transforming for all of Sanskrit students. But beyond all of this, there is one thing about Sanskritam that I think personally I have felt as one of the key points of Sanskritam. And that, I think, is the relationship between Sanskritam and Dharma. Because Sanskritam allows us to go further and realize what is our Dharma. So in Vedas, it is to say that our most innermost self is God. We are God. Aham Brahmasmi and Tattvam Asi. They all point out to the fact that our most innermost real self is that of God. So you can say that this is God. Okay, but then there again, we are living, so we have some purpose, we have something which is, we are not totally, even though we can say this, we cannot relate to it. So where do we put ourselves, like where do we see ourselves? So that's where dharma comes in. And dharma is kind of like our inner nature. It's our real nature. And our real nature has got lot of positive qualities. So I'll put another circle over here. And this is dharma. And this is like our nature. So it has positive qualities like how we can love and we can show empathy. We can have inspiration for doing charity and sharing and learning and taking efforts. All these are positive qualities that that is our real nature, and that is actually our dharma. That's actually when we connect with that, then we will be doing all of this. We will be sharing, we will be caring, we will be learning, we'll be more confident, there will be lack of fear, we'll have a lot of courage. That's all possible when we are connected with dharma. So these are all the positive points, but what happens is we frequently live our life somewhere over here. We go away from dharma. It's not like we don't know dharma. Dharma is our real nature. Everybody knows the dharma. But what happens is, because we don't prioritize it, we let other things distract us. We try to compromise our dharma. And when we compromise our dharma, we live somewhere over here. We are very far from God and dharma. And now, instead of love, we have hatred. Instead of charity, we have miserliness to keep things. Instead of confidence, we have fear of losing things, of bad things happening. So we have substituted all of those. Instead of confidence, we have lack of confidence. We have all the negative energies that we have attracted because we are not our real self. Our real self is dharma. It's all the positive qualities. If we are not connected to our real self, then we don't feel happy because that's not who we are. Share cannot become a goat. Simha cannot become a goat. Ajaha na bhavitum arhati. So why? Because that's not its nature, and that's why we attract unhappiness. Dharma gives us happiness. So why Sanskritam? Because Sanskritam is a way to go towards dharma. This is a very important reason that I personally feel that Sanskritam brings it. It makes the person a better person. The way the language is taught. So what do we do in Sanskritam? We learn Gita. Now my father always says, Gita is like you can say as Mama Dharma. Because it says, it starts with Dharma Kshetre, Guru Kshetre, and ends with Matir Mama. And then if you join that Mama Dharma, it's my dharma. So Gita is entirely about dharma. So then that's what we do in Sanskrit class. In the books, it is oriented based on Gita. So dharma comes in there. Then all the Subhashitas, most of them are instructions in dharma. Because they tell us some good things. They make us go towards this real nature. For example, in ashram, it's Subhashitam you must have seen that Santosha Trishu Kartavya Swadare Bhojane Dhane Trishu Chaiva Na Kartavya Adhyayane Tapa Dhana Yoga. So, teen cheezon mein santosh karna chahiye aur teen cheezon mein nahi karna chahiye. Lekin wo swabhavik nahi hai. Wo ek cheez hai jo humko jaankar uske upar vichar karkar uske upar jo hai we have to take action. So that's when we'll go to dharma. So this dharma, why is it so important? Because dharma gives us happiness. When we have dharma, we automatically become happy. And that's the goal of life, right? Because what else is there in life? Money is not happiness, but dharma is happiness. It's like dharma is for own dharma's sake. You don't have to wait for dharma to give the result after life. Dharma is itself happiness. When we connect with dharma, we will track all the positive energies. We will realize the real purpose of life. Because life has to be artha purna. It has to be, something has to be, there is a purpose behind life. And that is all connected with dharma. And this is how Sanskritam makes you go towards dharma. And it's like a door towards dharma. And once that door opens, then we can see the wealth that is there. And then we can, depending upon how much effort we have and how much interest we show, it's all available to us. But Sanskritam opens that way, because a lot of the Subhashitas, Gita, and the way we conduct the class is it's free of cost. So it's not like learning some other language by paying money. Tatarnaiva Bhavati. And the environment, the Gurukul, this is a very sacred place. So all of it is connection with dharma. So that's why I think one of the main reasons of learning Sanskritam is to connect with your real nature, which is dharma. And it's kind of like this. This is who we really are. God is who we really are. Dharma is kind of like who we should be on this, in this life. That is what dharma is representing. Who we should be. Because it is a blueprint given to us that, you know, these are the qualities you have, but you go away from it. If we stick to it, then this is what we should be. It's dharma. And this is what, where we usually are. Right? So, this kind of transformation, I think it happens. In my case, it has happened. So I don't say that, you know, I'm perfectly in sync with dharma. But it takes you towards dharma. Progressively makes you better. Makes you a better person. And you will attract more positive energies. You will do positive things. You will modify your thinking in a positive way. And ultimately, you will be more happy. And that, I think, is the biggest fruit of learning Sanskritam and teaching Sanskritam and being involved in activities related to Sanskritam. So this is what I wanted to share with you. And I'll go ahead with the program. With the